Okay, my dear student, so we were talking about the definition of compounds, and I said to you that lemon contains citric acid, and acids, as you know, or if you don't know, then acids are made up of different elements. So definitely if they are made up of different elements, so they are compounds. Okay, another example, if you don't have lemon, then you might have a substitute vinegar. Okay, you have a substitute if you don't have lemon, or you don't use lemon to make a salad. Okay, so we use vinegar instead of lemon. Okay, that comes in a bottle, transparent liquid, isn't it? I hope you have seen that transparent liquid, all of you. I hope all of you have seen that. Okay, vinegar contains acetic acid. The formula, molecular formula of acetic acid is CH3COOH. So the molecular formula tells you the story that it contains carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, different elements. It contains three kinds of different elements. So definitely it's a compound. Now I hope the concept of elements and compounds are clear to you. So what I am going to do is that I am writing some molecular formulas over here, and you have to do a classwork. That is, you have to identify which one is an element and which one is a compound. Before I give you the classwork, let me give you some more examples to make the concept more clear to you. So suppose I have a balloon. Suppose I have a balloon. Okay. And I have filled this balloon with a gas. And I said to you that this balloon contains hydrogen gas. The balloon contains hydrogen gas, and if you write the molecular formula, that is the smallest molecule, the formula of the smallest molecule of this substance which is inside this gas, which is inside this balloon, is H2. Okay, H2 stands for the molecule of hydrogen. It contains hydrogen. So this balloon consists of only one kind of particle, isn't it? Only one kind of atom, that is hydrogen. So definitely it's an element. Hydrogen is an element. So the definition which is written in your book tells us that elements are substances that cannot be split further into simpler substances by any chemical means. Okay, so this is a very interesting definition. The first definition I gave you was to understand the difference between compound and elements. And the second definition which is written in your book is that elements are substances which cannot be broken into simpler substances by chemical means. For example, hydrogen, which is in the balloon. So if you want to tell, or if you want to break this hydrogen into simpler substances, you cannot have simpler substances from hydrogen. Hydrogen is the simplest substance. is a simple substance in and of itself. You cannot extract other substances from hydrogen. Okay? And it is made up of only one kind of atom, that is hydrogen. And what does chemical mean means? Chemical means means the process, the methods, the processes, the methods by which a chemical change is brought into a substance, like burning, reacting, adding some reagents to this substance, burning, heating, and other sort of chemical means, methods. So if I take this water, the glass of water, it contains water, isn't it? And I asked you that what is the molecular formula of water, you will say definitely H2O. So as it is made up of different sort of elements, you will say this is a compound. So use this method, this technique which I just have explained you to do the classwork. I'm giving you a classwork, that is, I will be giving you molecular formulas of some substances, and you have to identify which one is an element and which one is a compound. Get ready for that.